Chickies, and welcome back to my channel. So I am actually in Mexico right now. I am in Cabo, staying at the Grand Villas Resort. I came here on vacation, stood the week, conquered, relaxed, drank a lot of pina coladas, and now it is time for me to go home. I'm actually checking out like literally in a few minutes, but before I check out, I really wanted to show you guys my suite because I thought it'd be pretty fun. I tweeted about it the other week if you guys wanted to see it, so this is it. I'm also recording on a brand new camera today. I got myself the M50 for Christmas, so we'll see how this works out. I hope it works out fine. Hey Chickies, so it's me coming to you live from bed, and I'm oily and I'm editing. However, I just wanted to say, as you guys saw, I said that I got a new camera and this whole video was filmed on that new camera, and re-watching the footage right now, some of the footage is a little grainy. I didn't really get to mess with the video settings before I started filming, so I messed with the video settings after the fact and fixed it. So this video, some parts might be like a little grainy, so I really apologize for that, but I adjusted it, and now for my future videos, everything will be just dandy. But sorry if that annoys anybody. Anyways, continuing with the video. I also don't have a room key on me right now, which is why I'm awkwardly trying to hold my door open. But anyways, we are in suite number 929 for reference, anybody that's gonna come here, but let's get started. Here's our beautiful wooden door, and I'm gonna take you inside. Anyways, we are now inside. These walls echo central, but it's okay. So this is our little hallway right here. Nice place to do a little runway show. And it's super cute over here, nice little walkway. We have some wonderful mirrors right here. And then we have closets, many closets right here. Open this up. Light turns on. I have a used robe at the top here because I threw it there. But this is where the robes would go, and a iron and an ironing board that I never touched. So yeah. Then we have in here, this is actually just one big closet. So in here, some hangers, those some spare pillows at the top, a safe, more spare pillows, and then this is like the hair dryer, and I actually don't know what this. No way. Oh my god, wait, this is a straightener. I didn't even know that. I've just been using the blow dryer, but this blow dryer here, super random, because you know how like most hotels have like really shitty blow dryers? This one, powerful as shit. Oh god, someone's calling our room. Now I'm going to bring you into the bathroom. So this is the bathroom, definitely one of my favorite parts of this suite. Dual sink, bunch of toiletries right here. We have little cups right here, a open bottle of toothpaste that I forgot to get rid of, and then the towels under here, and then over here, this is literally like the best part. This is a gigantic jacuzzi tub. This is so nice, and actually the other night when I got back from dinner, our concierge set it up with like a bunch of bubbles and flower petals and stuff, and oh my god, it was so nice. Then over here is the vanity. This is where I've been doing my makeup and just living my life. Nice little vanity, little toiletry thing here. This mirror is wonderful. It just pops out of the wall like that. So this shower is super nice. It has a rainfall head on it, and then it also has a like seating area, which is a little weird, but it really works really well when you're trying to shave your legs. And then we have some extra toiletries up there. So that is the shower. And then over here, the toilet. Basically it for the bathroom, so let me take you into the main area. Okay, so first over here, we have a little wine and espresso station. We have some Nespresso pods, some ice, some wine, like I said, super nice. And then we also have a drawer here that's literally just filled with snacks. It is awesome. Then also there's a little mini bar, if I could open it. Oh, I'm opening it the wrong way. There's a little mini bar down here too, which is super, super nice. Stacked with your faves. And then over here, this is just one of my luggages. Concierge actually came over before and took my other luggage, but I need this one because I still have a few things I need to put away, so that's there. And then we have a gigantic mirror right here, full length mirror, as you guys could see. I look great. I'm in my Fabletics set. So I'm actually wearing today from Fabletics. This set is so cute. It's part of the January collection. This is the Kessler Medium Impact Sports Bra. It is so adorable, and the back of it has all these little straps on it, and it's literally one of my favorites. And then these bottoms are the Kessler High-Waisted Strappy 7/8 Leggings, and I love these too. They have an internal pocket right here in the waistband, which is super nice. We're getting a phone call.
Hello?
Hi, yes, we are heading down in literally 2 seconds, just gathering some last minute things. Anyways, these leggings have a pocket right there, which is super nice. Cute little strappy detailing on the back. We love it. Anyways, moving along here, here is our bed. This bed is awesome, super comfortable. Over here, they also put some slippers on the ground, which is super nice. We have our little station here, bedside, and then this is like a little living room area, which is super nice. Little couch here, little couch there. We love it. And then over here, this is actually my beach bag. It's the one that the hotel gives. It's so cute and it just has like sunscreen in it. And then this is like a little office desk, but because I'm vacationing, I am not doing work. So I have not touched this desk once, but they provided us with chocolate covered strawberries and champagne, which is super cute, and shots because we are in Mexico and we do tequila here. And then this is definitely the best part. It is the balcony. This little balcony is so cute and OMG, what is that? We have Fabletics clothes all over the balcony. I set this up for you guys to show you some of my favorite January products. So let me tell you about them. This first outfit is one of my faves from the January collection. We have the Ren Sculpt Knit bra here. So cute with the high-waisted Sculpt Knit statement leggings. This red color is so nice. Has Fabletics logo detailing. The back of it is crisscross. We love this. And then we have the Poppy Seamless Sports Bra right here with the high-waisted Power Hold logo leggings. This purple color is gorgeous. This bra is double layered. It also has the Fabletics logo going across the top as well as the leggings on the side. These have wonderful compression, super cute, super awesome. And then over here we have the Pia Front Twisted LS top with the high-waisted Power Hold logo crop leggings. This top is so cute, perfect for January because it's long sleeve, and these tops also has little holes for your thumb, which is super nice. It's crisscross, Fabletics logo all around, so nice. Wonderful compression in these leggings. They're cropped. Love this outfit. And then the last outfit, this top is the Flora Seamless LS top with the high-waisted Power Hold 7/8 leggings. This mahogany color is beautiful. Has this beautiful beautiful floral embellishment kind of going all over it. It's a super breathable fabric. Has great compression, cropped fit, and the leggings are so great. Power Hold leggings are some of my favorites from Fabletics, so these are awesome. And remember guys, if you want to check out Fabletics, make sure to use my link below. It's fabletics.com/beautychickyyt. Okay, let's walk the talk. Let's not answer it because it'll make it seem like we're all the way down. All right guys, we are literally getting kicked out of our room right now because we need to leave for the airport. The concierge keeps calling us. But if you guys want to check out Fabletics, highly, highly suggest you do so. The January collection is so cute. And if you guys use my link, it is down below. You could get 2 for $24 leggings, 2 leggings for $24 when you become a VIP. So make sure to go to the link below, check it out, and become a Fabletics VIP for 2 for $24 leggings. Doesn't get better than that. All right, now we gotta go. We're in a really big rush. We're probably pissing them off. Let's go. All right, so made it to the airport, guys. I like ran out the door when I was talking to you guys last. There's this little girl behind me. When I was talking to you guys before though, I like ran out of the resort because our taxi was there and we were freaking out trying to get to it. But now we're at the airport, I'm going home. There's my flight, we about to zoom. You already know we rock Fabletics on this flight. Hey! Did I scare you? Anyways, little change of setup as we could tell. I'm back in New York. My last few clips were like a little screwed up. Basically, I was trying to finish filming my little suite room tour thing, but I was also trying to film it with like little to no time because I thought I was gonna have way more time before having to leave the resort, and then I ended up just not having enough times, and then people were calling us because we had to get out of the room because our car got there, and it was a lot. I'm just gonna tell you guys about my like experience after that. So basically, I left the resort around 12:30, got to the airport around 1:30, and then my flight was at 3. I flew at 3 p.m. till 6 p.m. and I landed at like 6:30-ish in Salt Lake City, Utah. And then I had a 5-hour layover. I can't talk. 5-hour layover in Utah. Luckily, I was flying Delta though, and my priority pass gives me like Delta Sky Lounge access. Yeah, that's it. So I just chilled out in there and ate all their food until it was time for my next flight. There was no earlier flight to New York, and when I was booking the flights, the shortest layover that there was the 5-hour layover. There was no direct flights from Cabo to New York, so that kind of sucked. Whatever though. So then finally at like 11 p.m., I got on my flight to New York, and I didn't land in New York until 5 in the morning. I landed at like 5:15, 5:30-ish, and then I got my bags, and I had to go on the train back to Long Island to my parents' house, because before I left for Cabo, I had like a bunch of Christmas gifts and like a bunch of like, you know, wintry clothes that I left at my parents', because I was like, I'm not going to need these for Mexico, so why would I bring the extra bulk with me? So I couldn't even go back to my apartment. I also didn't have my keys because I left my keys at my parents' house. So I had to get on the LIRR, which is the Long Island Railroad, I can't talk, and travel an hour and a half back to Long Island where my parents are, so I could go to their house and I could get my things and I could pack them up so I could bring everything back to Manhattan. But once I got to Long Island, before even going and doing all that, I went directly to urgent care. And now, if you guys have read my tweets, then you probably know why I went, but if you didn't, here's the deal. I got a really bad cut on my shin bone, and then while I was in Cabo, I was getting all the signs of infection, and then my calf started to really hurt and it was really painful, and I was like, I think my leg is infected. So when I got back to New York, when I got to Long Island, I went directly to urgent care and they were like, yup, you have an infection. I was like, great. So now I'm on antibiotics for the next 10 days to get rid of it. My leg already feels a lot better this morning, but it's still kind of in pain. It just feels like I have a constant pulled muscle, and where the actual wound is, it's very sore. So that's the deal with that. So after finding out that I have an infection in my leg from urgent care, my doctor was like, you should go to get a ultrasound. He wanted me to get an ultrasound in my leg. No, not my tummy. I tweeted that I got an ultrasound and I was like, I should probably clarify that. So I got an ultrasound in my leg because my doctor wanted to make sure I didn't have any blood clots and make sure that it wasn't like blood clots that were causing my leg pain. So I had to go and get an ultrasound in my leg. It was really weird and uncomfortable. It's whatever. So I got that done. There were no blood clots, thank God. Just a painful spazzy calf from my infection. So I went and I picked up my prescription, and then I went back to my parents and I packed up all my things. I took a 3-hour nap, and then I woke up and I came back to the city last night, and I spent my whole night last night unpacking, because I brought so many things with me to Mexico, but one of the things I brought that was like the biggest is my Fabletics stuff. No joke, my Fabletics stuff that I brought with me took up a good like half of my luggage. I brought two luggages, and of one of the luggages, a full one side of it was only athleisure. So shout out to Fabletics though, because I did end up wearing those, and you know, New Year 2020, I really wanted to bring my athletic clothing with me on my vacation because I wanted to be able to wake up, maybe go on a run on the beach or go to the gym and do that sort of stuff and just be a little active. Towards the end of 2019, I started slacking a lot in all aspects of life. I started slacking on YouTube, on all my other social media. I wasn't going to the gym anymore. I wasn't keeping up with my skincare. Wasn't keeping up with me in general. But long story short, I just really, like, the end of 2019 was just, like, not good for me. But it's 2020, new year, do you. And I hope you guys like that little saying. I love it. Fabletics told me about it. Instead of new year, new me, it's new year, do you. This is a new year. You guys don't have to transform to a whole new person. Just do the things that you feel you want to do to better yourself for the new year. So for me, new year do you means that I want to work out more. I want to do that. That's me doing me. I want to film more videos. Me filming videos and creating content is doing me. And just keeping up with self-care in general. So I love that little quote. You guys should definitely take it into consideration. Not new year, new me. new year, do you. Once again, if you guys are interested in any of the Fabletics stuff that I mentioned towards the beginning of the video, you guys could use my link and you'll get two leggings for $24 when you sign up to become a VIP. The VIP membership is so worth it. It's like the best. So of course, when you first sign up, it's two leggings for $24 as your introductory offer. You're gonna get two leggings for $24, which is amazing. So once you become a VIP, you get your two leggings for $24. At the beginning of each month, Fabletics releases a new collection. So once you're a VIP, you have the 1st through the 5th of each month to go and shop the collection. You can either shop the collection or you could decide to skip it. If you decide to skip shopping for that month, then you get a $49.95 credit charge. However, that credit goes into your Fabletics account, so it's not just like money being taken out of the bank. You could actually use your $49.95 credit to purchase things on the Fabletics website whenever you want. It's basically like a gift card that never expires, which is very nice because I know with some places they'll charge you a fee for like a monthly membership, but then that's just like a fee that they charge you. With this, Fabletics is charging you that fee, but you could actually use that $49.95 to purchase things on the Fabletics website whenever you want. So like I said, the gift card that doesn't expire. So it's super awesome. I highly suggest you guys go check it out. My link will be below, like I said. And yeah. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like I said, I know it's a little like all over the place, but I thought it's cute. And also one more thing. My like biggest New Year's resolution is to kick my perfectionist habits, which I've talked about this briefly on my YouTube channel like once, and then I made like a whole tweet thread about it the other day on Twitter. But honestly, kicking my perfectionist ways for the new year is definitely like one of my biggest New Year's resolutions, because my perfectionist ways just really take a burden on me and on my content. And sometimes like one little thing could be off my video, literally a hair could be out of place, and I will decide to trash the entire video and not upload it because of that one little thing, and I need to stop doing that. So for example, today's video, I like, it's fun and everything. However, because it's a little all over the place, like right now, it's honestly making me a little anxious to edit, but I'm sure it's gonna turn out fine and I'm sure you guys are gonna love it. So we're starting out 2020. I'm gonna edit this video. I'm going to get it up for you guys no matter how all over the place it is. Sometimes the most perfect videos are the imperfect ones, and I keep trying to tell myself that, and slowly but surely I'm learning and I'm getting that in my head, and hopefully it will help me to produce more content for you guys in the new year. So now that's the last little thing I wanted to say. I'm actually going to go now. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a big thumbs up and stay subscribed to my channel and follow me on all my social media. My username is beautychicky literally everywhere. I don't know if you guys heard that. I just like, it's my nails. Anyways, I'm gonna go. I need to edit this video, but I hope you enjoyed for the 100th time, and I'll talk to you guys in my next video. With all that being said, ciao, ciao, chickies. Mwah.